Hi, welcome to my tutorials on Euclid's Elements, Book 3. This video presentation is going to be on Proposition 33 of Book 3, which gives us the methods to construct, on a given line segment AB, a circle segment such that the circle segment admits the angle C. So we're going to do this first for an acute angle C. The first thing we're going to do is to copy the angle C onto the point A. Next, we're going to draw a line perpendicular to DA from the point A, bisect the line BA. From the point F, draw a line perpendicular to BA. And now where this line intersects AE, we label that point G. Draw the line BG. Looking at these two triangles, we have that FA is equal to FB because we bisected this line at point F. FG is common. A right angle on one side of the line is equal to a right angle on the other side of the line. So we have two triangles with side, angle, side, side, angle, side. According to Proposition 4, these two triangles are equal. In other words, AG is equal to GB. Which means that if we draw a circle with the center at G and the radius of GA, it will go through the point A and through the point B. So let's do that. Now the circle segment ABE admits the angle C. To prove this, let's look at our line DA. DA is perpendicular to AE, and AE is the diameter, and A is the extremity point of the diameter. So according to Proposition 16 of Book 3, DA touches the circle. Now DAB is equal to C. And if DAB is equal to C, then the angle admitted in the circle segment on the opposite side will also be equal to C, according to Proposition 32 of Book 3. But we've created DAB, or constructed DAB, equal to C. So in other words, this angle C is equal to this angle C, which is equal to this angle C, and thus we have created our circle segment, accepting the angle C. So there we've demonstrated this proposition for an acute angle. Now we will do the same thing for a right angle. Now C is a right angle, and we have our line AB. Using the same methods we used for the acute angle, we will copy the angle C to the point A. We will bisect AB. The intersection point is F. Draw a circle with the center at F. Radius of FA. And now this semicircle admits the angle C. Proof. Like before, DA touches the circle since DA is perpendicular to AB and AB is the diameter. So therefore, the angle admitted inside of this circle segment is the same as this angle here, which is a right angle. So this is a right angle. This is a right angle, and we started off with a right angle. So there we have demonstrated the construction methods when C is a right angle. Finally, we will give you the construction methods for an obtuse angle. Again, we have line AB, and we will copy the angle C to the point A. We will draw a line perpendicular to A. Perpendicular to AD. We will bisect AB at point F. Draw a line perpendicular to AB from the point F. And where these two lines intersect, we will label it G. Again, looking at BGF and FGA, we have two triangles where this is equal to this. This is common. And The two angles are also equal because they're right angles. So we have a side, angle, side, side, angle, side, proposition 4, book 1, these two triangles are equal. In other words, AG is equal to BG. And consequently, if we draw a circle with G as the center, GA as the radius, it will also pass through the point B. And now we have that this circle segment admits the angle C. Proof. Well, again, the line AD is the extremity of the circle diameter, which is at where, and it is also at right angles. So the line AD touches the circle. And we have a line touching a circle with an angle C. So in the opposite circular segment, it admits the angle C. Well, C was copied from our original angle, and consequently, this angle is equal to our original angle. So here is our circle segment that admits that angle. And thus we have shown how to draw a circle segment with an acute angle, a right angle, and an obtuse angle, such that the circle segment admits that angle. And that concludes this video presentation. To see the next presentation, just click the next button.